This episode is brought to you by Soapazon. Get your baseball soap, gear up for opening day. You don't want to be smelly when you're watching opening day with the boys. Soapazon.com, promo code TAP, T-A-P. Get your soap at 15% off. You can get a subscription. You can get a one-off order. Either way, you're getting 15% off. Use promo code TAP. So this episode is brought to you by Soapazon. Get your soap today. Opening day is right around the corner. Don't be so smelly.
Going back to take a pitch. How you doing?
Hey, I had a little rhythm there.
Yeah, well, a little song. No dance though, sadly.
No dance. Right,
maybe right. Next. Maybe next time.
Yeah, I mean, we don't dance. We'll give TikTokers a chance to dance.
We generally only dance on our OnlyFans. Hit the link in our bio. Check out our OnlyFans. We never do content together.
No, never. It's all separate.
Max has this beautiful, what is it? It's a chase, right? That's what they call those.
Oh my god!
Yeah, that he poses on. So check out our OnlyFans.
I love how this is the beginning of the episode. We're talking about OnlyFans, and we don't actually have us.
Yes, we do. I signed us up for one.
Jeez, that scares me. I didn't even know
it's in
that.
The bio.
You're going rogue. You're going rogue.
Why would I tell you?
That's fair.
I'm not tell you anything. It's not going to be that. Go on.
We're under a week from opening day, man.
Yes, sir.
We survived the winter.
That was heat. Hell yeah.
Oh, man. There were times where I was really wondering if we were going to survive or not. This off season got really slow for a while.
Yeah.
Like, really slow.
It went quick, though. I mean, you know, when we had spring training at the end of February and then World Baseball Classic, you know? So
I think the World Baseball Classic helped us out a lot just to get meaningful games. I mean, regardless of how you feel about it, it was good baseball. The game of baseball won.
There's no way anybody hates the World Baseball Classic.
Right.
There's no way. I mean, that's just you're wrong if you say that, you know?
Yeah. I mean, listen, I hate that there's the potential for injury, as we saw with Diaz and Altuve and Wainwright, right? Wainwright.
Freddie. There's plenty. You know?
There are plenty of guys. Obviously not as significant as Diaz and Altuve, of course, but
yeah,
those were both things that it happens. You know, Diaz was a freak injury. Altuve's was just a pitch that got away from Daniel Bard. We'll get to that in a little bit.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm going to say this. I can't wait for the 2026 World Baseball Classic, because I genuinely believe we're going to see a lot more of the American top tier starters in that one. I think that's going to be one where the best of the best are going to play.
It's possible. I mean, why? Why do you think that?
With that, how many guys came out and said, hey, you know, this was great. I would do this again, blah, blah, blah. I think some of these guys are going to realize, hey, we're going to pitch for our country. Might as well. Can't pitch in the Olympics because major leagues aren't allowed. You know, there's no other international event for the U.S. There's no, you know, Dominican leagues or anything like that to where you represent the country.
Hmm.
This is, and Wainwright said it best, you know, this is his first time representing America. And it's been a dream he's had. So these guys have been wanting to represent USA forever, for their entire lives. I mean, Pete said it best, you know, he'd have to rip them off the field once you get him on there. I think because of how positively people have been speaking about this experience, Mike Trout said it was the funnest 10 days of baseball, I think it was, right?
Something like that, yeah.
But the funnest. Not the most fun, but the funnest. Ohtani had a great experience. He said, you know, all this stuff, Lars Nootbaar, granted, he won the World Baseball Classic.
Lars Nootbaar. Yeah, I have to put this out. he went into the World Baseball Classic like the day before he, or the morning of that, he joined Team Japan, something like that. He had 54,000 followers, I think.
How many does he have now?
I think he has something like almost 600 or 700,000 now.
Jeez.
Let me fact check. Yeah, he definitely started with like, no, now he has 924,000.
What?
He's jumped up almost a million followers.
Listen, good for him.
Yeah.
Good for him. But like, and that's the thing. The World Baseball Classic puts these guys on such a stage where, what?
I typed in Lars on Instagram, and I guess for some reason there's like a, I guess it's trending or something, but it's Larsa Pippen.
Oh, God.
So.
Oh, God.
I know something with that. She like, she said that she fucked four dudes a day throughout her entire marriage to Scottie Pippen. Something like that.
I wonder why that dude hated everyone.
Obviously, extreme cap, but yeah, she said something like that.
Let's play Factor Cap. Non-baseball edition. But yeah, no. The World Baseball Classic puts these guys on a global stage, and that's really the point of it. And
yeah,
I mean, come on, let's look at Trey Turner's performance.
Mm-hmm.
How many Americans actually like Trey Turner? Not that many. Only the Dodgers fans and Nats fans and now Phillies fans. Not many other diehards or casuals like Trey Turner like that. Dude's out here showing up for his country, hitting bomb after bomb after bomb. Did it again today in spring training. First spring training game back. He hit another home run.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you know, and as a Mets fan, I like Trey Turner. I hate days in Philly, but I like Trey Turner a lot. Does it help that he went deep for my country? God knows how many times. Yeah, 100%. America first, but you know, the whole thing. I guess it enhanced the allure of these superstars.
Okay. I loved it. Mm-hmm.
I don't love the whole games at 5 a.m.
No. Yeah, that's a big fat no for me.
I don't love that. Like, I wanted to watch the Czech Republic play this year. Yep. I was so excited.
Didn't get to watch a single game.
I'm not doing that.
Yeah.
Those are my thoughts on the WBC. Now that it's all said and done.
I mean, Japan won. Credit where credit is due. They're a great team.
I know you were USA, 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 but you knew that deep down that this Japanese team was so good.
Yeah.
That they were going to fight for the title.
Yeah. I think that everyone underestimated the USA for whatever reason. I mean, look at that lineup. That lineup was, I'd say, its next best lineup was probably Venezuela.
They didn't even get the love they deserved either.
And I would say, still, USA, starting lineup and bench was at least 40 times stronger than Venezuela, and they were the second best, in my opinion.
Yes. No doubt.
Japan was a very good lineup, too. They play baseball. They have a different way to play. They play
technical baseball.
It's different.
It's fun.
So, yeah, I mean, obviously anybody could win. It's a very, very short tournament. Mm-hmm. And once you get past pool play, you win, look at Mexico, right? Never thought that Mexico could have, you know, gotten that far. I picked them to maybe get through pool play, but mm-hmm.
I didn't think that they were done right off the bat. Right after pool play, you thought they were counting them out.
I mean, I don't know if I said that, but
to me, you did. I don't know if it was on record, but I know you said it to me.
Are you sure?
I think so.
I don't think so.
I'm like 90% sure.
I think you're making shit up.
It's possible.
But anyway, Mexico, you don't think of them in baseball. You don't think of them as a powerhouse baseball team. So, you know, like they were a great team. They got to the final four. They were two outs away from going to the finals, you know, so.
And while we're on Mexico, how about the newest Mexican superstar in baseball, Randy Arozarena? I mean, this dude is the best big game player we've seen in a long time. He's what James Shields wished he was. Can we talk about that semifinal game that Arozarena had? Dude put on a show. A show. And he even said that was bigger than his World Series home run. You know? Oh my God.
Yeah. And
Cuba to beat Japan so that way he could knock out Cuba.
Right.
In the final, right? I think that's what it was. Because he defected from Cuba, I believe.
Yes.
Which, by the way, let's just touch on that real quick. Cuba's bullpen catcher not making the flight.
Yep.
I don't know if he overslept or if that was on purpose. I'm gonna give him the benefit of the doubt and say it was on purpose. But man,
seems like it was on purpose.
Yeah. No, I wish him the best of luck, and I'm praying for his family. Man, that's not a good thing to. I mean, it's a good thing to do for himself, but. Kind of think of your family at that point, too.
What if he doesn't have family?
Right. Now, obviously, that's a different story, but.
Yeah.
I mean, Grant, he's a bullpen catcher. I'm not sure what his plan is here, but, you know, good luck to him.
He'll become a bullpen catcher.
I think
he's got experience.
I think he's the first Cuban to defect during the World Baseball Classic.
Yes.
But not the first during an international competition, from what I remember.
Oh, so like you're mean like during like Olympics or something?
Yeah.
Or FIFA.
Olympics. Yeah, wherever it is. Yeah. Because I know the Cuban Baseball Federation or whatever it is extended invites to certain MLB players, but not players who were critical of the government, defected during international events. And then there's one other thing, and I forgot what it was. Which is why you only saw two or three guys from the majors on the Cuban team, despite
Moncada,
the abundance of Cuban talent. Yeah.
I mean, who else?
I think that was it.
No. Who else? Who else would there have possibly been?
Oh, well, we talk about guys like Arozarena, Chapman, Gurriel. Yeah.
Gurriel.
Yeah, all those guys. And a couple infielders. I can't remember the name. I can find it.
Yeah.
But yeah, there's an abundance of Cuban talent.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, Nestor.
Yeah.
Nestor is one that it's just.
But Nestor is American.
I think because his family defected.
His parents, right?
Yeah. I believe so.
Well, Nestor was going to be on Team USA. And I'll tell you right now, we got Nestor in that finals. USA is a
different game.
Yeah.
Whole different game.
They scored what? What was it?
Two runs.
Two? Yeah, it was 3-2. Yep. So I think it's hard to say. But I think it's a different game.
That, and obviously, you know, as we see the bracket, you know, we saw it unfold and it was USA Japan. That's what everybody thought from the beginning.
Yep.
And then everybody's automatically going to Shohei versus Trout.
Yep.
Which, in a tournament run by Major League Baseball, the scenario that everyone wanted ends up being the scenario that determines this tournament. I'm just saying, no. Get the tinfoil hats out.
It's pretty impossible to set that up.
Right, exactly.
But I don't know how you would possibly do that.
Voodoo. But it was impressive, and it showed that. Hey, first of all, can we talk about that final pitch from Shohei? That was one of the filthiest pitches I've ever seen.
How about that fastball right down the fucking middle?
Yeah, that Trout couldn't keep up with because Trout's washed.
No, he's not washed, but
no, he's not washed. But like, this is the most meaningful baseball he's played in his career.
yep.
Did he show up when it mattered most? Not really.
No, and I was really looking at it. He only got hits off of schlubs.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't get any like special hits off of anybody good. Like his one home run was off of Canada, which USA put up like a 27 spot in the first inning. Like
yeah, against I was the kid's
name. Yeah, that kid. I can't remember his name.
I feel so bad for that kid.
I can picture him, but
yeah,
I don't feel bad for him. I actually envy him.
Getting to pitch that lineup and just that experience, yeah. But I feel bad that he got rocked and didn't make it out of the inning.
Yeah, but how many people can say that right. They faced that lineup? Now only a handful.
Well, he didn't even face the whole lineup. He got through six hitters or something like that, right?
Yeah, but still, I think five. But still, he faced.
But yeah,
five potential Hall of Famers.
Right, out of six hitters. Yeah. By the way, the list of Cuban players includes Jose Abreu, Yordan Alvarez, Yasmani Grandal, Chapman, Rosenbrand as well. Just some notable names. Aledmus Diaz as well.
Mm-hmm.
Some guys that definitely would have helped Cuba show it. Which, I know you're wrong, Cuba, you know, because they got out of the group stage on the tiebreak, they played good baseball up to get to Miami. But they got their shit handed to them.
Yeah.
By the Americans. I'm just trying to see if there's any other notable names. Because I remember there was a list. That I just can't find. But. Yeah.
It's all right. Well, yeah. I mean. World Baseball Classic was, I'll give it an A+.
I was about to say, yeah, what, you got to give it a grade. What you got going A+?
You want me to do 1 to 10?
Yeah, go ahead.
10.
I'm going to give it a 9.8. I'm going to take 0.2 points off for the 5 a.m., 6 a.m. games. But other than that, it was a phenomenal tournament. Yeah, an A+. But
you have to do that, though.
Have to do it, yeah.
Because of time zones. I mean, they're on the opposite side of the world, so.
Yeah, but again, it was a perfectly done tournament. And you know, we mentioned Altuve, we started when they are open, but you know, he broke his thumb, it was.
Yes.
Pitched by Daniel Bard now. Let's just put it out here right away. I saw some idiot people saying Bard did that on purpose and this and that. Now, obviously, those are dumbass fans who don't understand that throwing a baseball at 98 miles an hour and controlling it is incredibly difficult to begin with. Just to be able to get to that point. The fact that Daniel Bard had thrown, what was it, 8 of his 12 pitches for balls?
Like at that point? Something like that, maybe even more.
He had no control like that in it.
Yeah, literally.
Absolutely zero. And he just, I thought it was a broken hand, not even a thumb. I thought it hit the top of Altuve's hand.
Oh, you thought it hit his?
The top of the left hand.
Yeah.
When it came in, he went like this. And I thought it hit here. But I guess it glanced and got the back of the thumb, which is very interesting.
Yeah, I wasn't sure where it hit him immediately. I just knew it was definitely something pretty bad by his reaction.
Yeah, he was holding that like this. He could not move it at all.
He was literally just stiff. So
and again, you know, you talk about just freak injuries. Bard had no control. Altuve is a smaller guy. It's one of those things where it could happen. It's a baseball play, though, as opposed to a freak injury like Diaz.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's the risk. These guys know these risks.
Uh-huh.
You know, and they've talked about playing for their country is the highest honor in baseball for them and this and that. So
yeah, it is very different. It's not even remotely the same thing. So, like, it happened during the same thing. You know, they both happened during the World Baseball Classic, but they're two completely different injuries.
Yeah, and I don't think they're meaningless games. I don't think so.
No, they're not. I mean, they're meaningless to your favorite team.
Mm-hmm.
They're not meaningless, though. They're meaningless to the MLB season, but they're not meaningless. And to say that they're meaningless is kind of wild. Yeah, I mean,
if anything, I think it helps a lot, especially hitters, just get into a groove. And if your team's sending hitters, I see no negatives because they're getting more extra ABs in legit game action as opposed to spring training where some single A schlub is going up there just trying to make the best of it. And you're just having this guy out there to track his pitches and get to see game action.
That's funny, actually, because I was actually thinking the same thing the other day.
Mm-hmm.
So I went through a bunch of guys who played in the World Baseball Classic in 2017, mm-hmm. and how their stats compared from 2016 to 17.
And?
Most of them had much better years in 2017.
Yeah.
I didn't check any pitchers, but yeah.
I mean, and going back to the Cubans, Yandy Diaz, Jorge Soler, Jose Iglesias.
It's okay.
I'm saying, you think about some of these names, Cuba could have won. Rizal Iglesias in the back end of the bullpen, Adrian Morejo.
I don't know about could have won.
With Gurriel's, you know, just a bunch of these guys. Oh, yeah,
the 40-year-old and the slightly above average hitter.
Weig.
Oh, yeah. Puig. He's too busy playing in fucking Korea right now.
He's in Korea?
Korea. Yeah, I still follow him on Instagram.
Hell yeah. But
I mean, possibly a better team. Yeah, I'll give you that.
They wouldn't have had to rely on a tiebreaker, let's be real. They probably wouldn't have had to rely on a tiebreaker to get a full play. But
you never know. Anything could happen in one game. Small tournament.
But yeah, no, it's the WBC is not meaningless. It helps hitters. And you'd be foolish to think it's meaningless. Spring training, on the other hand, yeah. Meaningless games, but you need spring training.
Right.
That's how I see it.
Yeah. I agree. But, you know, while some people are bitching and complaining about injuries that can happen in the World Baseball Classic and meaningless games and then people coming back, these things can happen in spring training. Those are also meaningless games. And that just so happened to happen today.
Yeah, I mean, non-contact injuries are the worst. Because you know if it's a non-contact injury, it's most likely something bad.
And
Rhys Hoskins, man, I feel so bad for the dude.
Yeah.
I mean, tore his ACL. Hey. And it was an awkward-looking play, too. Like, I don't know if you saw the video, right?
Yeah.
He, like, tried to plant and then swing around, it looked like, almost. Going back on a ball over first base.
I think he thought that it was going to keep going or it was going to go further. So he corrected too late. And
just an awkward looking play. And he went down and you knew off the bat. As soon as he went down, that was it.
Should I play the video?
You have it?
No, right now. I'm doing a post.
No.
Should I play it?
Yeah.
All right.
Payoff pitch. And it's a high bouncer to first. Hoskins backs up in and out of his glove. And so Meadows will be on. And Hoskins clutching his knee.
That's not a good sign.
So, yeah. I mean, that was clearly ugly. And
again, you feel bad for the guy, too, at that point.
Well, yeah. No, of course. And, you know, injuries suck. the Phillies are now going to be without their first baseman for the past 6 years, right?
Yeah, he's going to free agent year.
Yep. So, yeah, they'll probably be without him most likely all year. ACL tears, crazier things have happened. So I'm not going to completely count him out for this year, but you know, ACL tears generally take at least 6 months and can take up to 12 months. And sometimes even longer if you don't progress correctly, you know? Yeah. So,
or if you try to rush back.
Yeah.
And I'm watching the video one more time. Just it's,
yeah.
It wasn't even a pop fly. It was a ground ball chopper that just got to go back on, which is really interesting, actually, how he handled, played them.
Yeah, I'd have to watch it again.
It was.
All right. Bad for the guy, and he missed it. And then
he
did a little skipped to Medulla.
It's just an awkward play all around. And I think at the end of the day.
Yep, just overcorrected.
It's a massive blow to the Phillies, who have high hopes this year. They have high expectations this year, especially after coming off the World Series run. Hoskins
nationally
into his contract year.
Yeah,
looking to compete. They brought in Trey Turner, looking to compete with the Mets and the Braves for the division. You know, this is a team that was, by all means, ready to go, getting Bryce Harper back by mid-June, early July, adding a piece there that they had. But, you know, they had have a deep lineup beforehand. Now you add Bryce Harper in, but you're taking away Rhys Hoskins. Granted, Harper is a two-time MVP, and you're going to get help there no matter what.
Yeah.
But you're relying on Derek Hall now at first base.
Mm-hmm. Pretty rough.
There's not much out there in terms of rough. Hang on. You're a first baseman. You're talking about something that's rough. I have the guy for the Phillies, and his name is Darren Ruff. I think they've heard of him before. They may have some prior experience, but if you need him, take him. Well, I know Yankee fans are saying IKF is available.
Well, I was going to suggest something, and Macca might be on board with this. Ready? Three-team trade.
Okay. Oh, okay. All right.
Mets give up Darren Ruff.
Okay.
Yankees give up IKF.
Both going to the Phillies.
Both going to the Phillies. Yeah.
Okay.
In return.
Let's hear it.
The Yankees get Bryce Harper.
Okay.
And in return on the Mets side, you give them
Painter.
Yeah, Painter. Yeah.
I feel like it's a fair deal.
I think it's pretty fair.
I can't wait for the Phillies fans to come for our heads for that one.
Just for that, I'm gonna put it into baseball trade values and see what comes back. But go on.
Yeah, I don't hate that deal actually at all. I think it's a great deal for all teams involved. Phillies get a lot of key depth pieces that they need. Painter's hurt, so he's useless to them anyway.
Yeah.
I mean, he sent him to the Mets, so the Mets are known for having their pitchers get hurt. It's a win there.
Exactly.
He's not going to burn you. And then he brings Harper to the Yankees. He's hurt now, and he isn't like New York anyway. He's not going to play well there. It's a win all around. Actually, the Phillies win this trade.
I'd say so.
Absolutely win this trade. I don't care what MLB trade value says. They're not taking the intangibles into play.
But
the fact that we can justify that is just bad.
So seriously though,
no, it's a huge blow to the Phillies.
No, it is. And Darren, not Darren Ruff, Derek Hall.
He's gonna be under the microscope, I think, now.
Yeah.
Because that's gonna determine really what happens next year too. Because again, Hoskins is a free agent coming up this year. Granted, mm-hmm. I think he'll re-sign back on either a qualifying offer or a 1-year deal.
Mm-hmm.
Because he wants that, either he's gonna need to continue rehabbing there or wants to stay a Philly. I don't know the first base market.
Harper's got a no trade clause, so I'm gonna
take a wait. I'm sure he'd waive it.
I'll give Yankees Wheeler. Ooh, or JT Realmuto.
Well, no, they have Trevino. They don't need a catcher. Give them a left fielder.
Schwarber?
Yeah.
Okay. But that's
a fair trade.
Go on. Yeah. I mean, I feel bad. I feel bad for Hoskins. I feel bad for Phillies fans, I guess.
I do. I really do. Cause they finally had it. They were just so close to really.
What's finally?
Because they've been mediocre since God knows when, for however long it's been.
Yeah, since and like
I start, 20, you start to feel bad for
14.
No.
Longer. What do you mean longer?
It's like 2012. All right, so just for the record.
Okay.
The best first base free agent coming up is Joey Votto, who has a club option, I believe. Yep.
Who's second best?
Josh Bell, who has a player option.
He's better. I don't know where you came up with Joey Votto is better.
It was just the first one I saw.
Come on.
And then Max Muncy has a club option with the Dodgers.
Also better.
Yeah, I know. Brandon Belt and CJ Cron are the two guys who
also better aside and also from better.
Hoskins are have no club option, no option attached to them. Mm-hmm. G-Mon Choi, Jesus Aguilar, Eric Hosmer. Mancini has a player option. So Rhys Hoskins, he's probably gonna end up going back to the Phillies when all is said and done. But there are some options if the Phillies do wanna try and capitalize on whatever window they seem to think they have. Or they can just try and get Shohei, but that doesn't help them at first base.
I mean, you're going to have to give up your entire farm system right now.
Yeah.
Even if it is just 1 year, you're still going to have to give up a lot to get Shohei right now. I mean, hey, that's it's the way the cookie crumbles sometimes, right? Every team deals with injuries. Nobody's special. Every team has injuries, and that's that. It's just the way right. that it goes.
And Braves fans are sitting here like, oh, let's fucking go. Mets without Diaz, those without Hoskins, you know, and then without Harper until mid June, early July. Braves fans are licking their chops right now.
Iglesias is down for at least a week. He's not touching a baseball.
Oh, for a week. Yeah.
He's going to get reevaluated. He's not going to be ready for I think so. Inflammation. Not going to be ready for opening day, and that's all they know as of right now. So don't put your money on it, and then you look at it. I just learned this from my homie Braves content on Instagram. Ian Anderson and Bryce Elder suck. Mm-hmm. So they have, no matter what, their fifth starter
is a rookie.
It's going to be a rookie, a guy with no major league experience.
But who's the guy that pitched against the Mets? Schuster, right? His name is?
I don't know. Schuster and Dodd are the two options.
Schuster. He looks good. He's surprising me.
I didn't see Schuster at all, but I did watch some footage of Dodd, and I liked his numbers in the minor leagues better. So, personally, I would pick him. But
yeah.
Either way, a guy with no major league experience,
he'll have an 8-year deal by July, so it's fine.
Depends how he does, but
okay, fine, by August.
So you add that in, they're going with Orlando Arcia at shortstop,
as opposed to Grissom. Yeah.
Grissom is not breaking camp.
And neither is the other guy.
Who's the other guy? Brennan Shoemake. And then you got Eddie Rosario in left field. You have, who's even their center fielder now? You still have Marcelo Zuna on your fucking team.
Heredia?
Oh, it's Michael Harris.
Listen, he's right up there with Nimmo. In terms of top center fielders in the game in the league, in the division, definitely.
Mm-hmm.
but
the MLB.
Expect a little regression from Harris this year. And you said it best on Instagram, and I wholeheartedly agree.
Yeah.
The numbers, when you look at his baseball savant numbers, what was it? He's 7th percentile in chase rate.
None of his stats to where it puts him on base were good. I don't know if he was getting lucky. I should have looked at his BABIP numbers and everything. But yeah, I mean, it's pretty clear as day if you know anything about sabermetrics and swing paths and everything that goes beyond that. Pretty easy to say that you'll see some regression out of him. And I believe me and Mac were talking about that towards the end of last year. I like him. I think that he will be a good player, but
yeah,
the Braves are also notorious for not progressing these type of players into their
BABIP was 361.
That's pretty good.
That was pretty good.
So he was getting maybe getting a little lucky. So we'll see. I mean, that's really it. We'll see. It's nobody could say one thing or the other, and you know, to say it as a fact is wrong. You know, state your opinion as to why. Sure. Back it up with
numbers. Yeah, I'd love to know why.
But, I mean, if you just take a quick glance at his Baseball Savant page, hits the ball hard. He's a tremendous defender. He has great speed. But his...
Right, and we're not denying that he's good. He's got talent.
No, he's
great.
We're not
denying that by any means.
I think I had him at the fourth or fifth. Best.
I think I had him a little lower because I don't.
Yeah, you did.
He's too high.
Yeah,
I think I have him at 8. I think.
Yeah, whatever it was, but yeah, I mean, that's neither here nor there. Rhys Hoskins is sadly out for the year, most likely. And we'll see. We'll see what the Phillies do.
It'll be interesting, and what the trade market looks like too, or.
You do not want to trade for anybody right now.
Gets cut at the end of spring training, who's a roster casualty, or who declines their options
as a
guy like Luke Voit, who accepted his option to Brewers, I think, right?
I think so. I still think that they're going to go with Derek Cole no matter what.
I think so too.
Yeah. So.
So let's go into it. I mean, It is less than a week before opening day.
Uh-huh.
And this is usually about the time where you and I look ahead. Let's talk about some predictions, shall we?
I say we shall.
All right. So let's start off with our favorite division and the best in baseball. Uh-huh. Who you got winning the East, the NL East?
Braves.
I have the Mets winning despite it all still. All right.
Old.
Who you got winning the Central?
Cardinals.
Yeah, I'm in the same boat there. How about the West?
Dodgers.
I have the Padres.
Bold.
You know what? I'm feeling bold today.
You're taking the underdogs to finally punch through and achieve it.
If they can do it, I can do it too, you know? All right, so give me your 3 wild cards.
My 3 wild cards are the Mets, Mets, Padres, and... Why can't I think of the last one? Who was it? Didn't we agree?
Oh, did we?
Yeah. Who are yours?
All right. Since you're not here, ready to play. I have the Dodgers, Braves. Well,
I wasn't expecting you to do it this way.
Oh, okay.
So I was gonna put it up, but
you put it up. Yeah, put it up. Let everybody see the NL, how it looks.
Yeah, but you started it differently to where it wouldn't work if I went this way. So anyway, yeah, I had the Mets, Padres, Phillies for my wild cards.
Now, obviously, the Hoskins injury changes a lot, where the Phillies may be on the outs.
Changes absolutely nothing for me.
You still think they're a wild card team? Okay.
Yeah.
It depends on how they can handle the first few months without Bryce and Derek Hall, Manning first. If they struggle early on, it's going to be an interesting climb for them.
Who do you think is right on the outside?
I feel like you can never count out the Brewers.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like, you know, we talked about this, the Diamondbacks might be a sneaky team. I don't know if they're going to be right outside the playoff hunt. They're going to be there, I think, early September. They'll be in the race.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe the Cubs, maybe.
Giants?
There is a large gap between, maybe the Giants. There is a large gap between the six we mentioned and everybody else.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't say large. I do think that the Phillies and the Brewers are relatively close.
Right, as we saw last year as well.
Yeah.
All right. How do you want to do the? You want to put it up on the screen for everybody to see?
Yeah.
And then you can orchestrate however you wanted the segment to go that I fucked up. By the way, while Billy's trying to figure out how he's going to organize it, check us out on all social medias. At Take a Pitch everywhere. Yeah, I'm plugging it in the middle of a segment. I don't give a damn. At Take a Pitch on TikTok, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, all that stuff. Yeah, check us out.
All right.
So before we move to the AL, who do you think comes out of the National League?
Wins the NL? Who wins the
pennant? Yeah, because you said obviously these are the top six teams. So which of these teams really is going to take control and run the table in the playoffs and make it to the World Series in the NL?
Hard. Very hard.
I think it comes down to five of the six, with the Phillies being the odd man out. But then again, if we counted them out last year, we would have looked like idiots. So.
I'm gonna be bold.
What do you got?
I'm gonna say it.
What do you got? Uh-oh. Let's hear it.
I'm gonna pick the Mets.
72-90. Here we come. you know what? And I'm gonna be just as bold. I'm gonna go Padres.
Is that just as bold?
Well, I don't know. You said it's bold. I think I had them winning the division.
Yeah, but they made the fucking NLCS last year.
It's fair. What, should I pick the Cardinals to be bold?
And they signed the fucking world.
That's true. That's true.
Spent almost fucking $1 billion in contracts this year.
I do think that they're one of the top three teams in the NL. So I'm going to pick the Padres. We haven't beat the Mets in the NLCS, and that's going to hurt like a motherfucker.
Okay.
To last year.
Interesting.
Doesn't mean I'm rooting for that, but I'm thinking.
All right.
Sorry, I had a little a feeling of pain come over for me. How about the AL? Let's go over to the AL, though.
Let's move on over to the AL.
Why don't we do it differently here? You list who you have winning everything in the AL, and we'll go from there.
All right.
Mine.
So I have the Yankees in the East, the Guardians in the Central, Astros in the West, Blue Jays as wild card one, Mariners as wild card two, and the White Sox as wild card three. What do you got?
I got five of those six teams, almost in the same order. Yankees win the division.
It is the same order.
No.
What?
You must have put it wrong on the graphic. No. Yankees win the division. Cleveland winning the Central. The Astros winning the West. Seattle with the first wild card. Toronto in the second wild card. And I have Baltimore coming in winning the third wild card.
Oh, you did.
Yep.
It's all right.
Now, I do think the Altuve injury is interesting because if the Astros struggle with David Helsley and Mauricio Dubon at second base early, the Mariners could very easily jump out to a huge lead in the division, depending on how badly the Astros struggle.
One guy.
It's Jose Altuve. He does kind of set the table there.
It's the Astros.
It is. So we'll see. It'll be very interesting to see. I do think the Mariners go back to the playoffs again. And they're such a fun team to watch, man.
Yeah, I mean, the AL is a lot more
secure.
I was going to say flip-floppy.
Oh, well, you mean any given year anyone can do anything?
I'm saying this given year anybody could do anything. I mean, the only locks that I have for the playoffs are the Yankees, Astros, and I guess the Blue Jays. Those are the only
Guardians.
I wouldn't say it's a lock. Not even close.
Okay.
The AL Central is so fucking bad.
It's garbage. I know it's garbage. Yeah.
But if you could somehow squeak out 140 games out of Carlos Correa and Byron Buxton, that could change a lot of things.
That's true. It's very true.
Now,
I mean,
getting them to play that much.
Are you talking about combined games or each?
Each. If you could get 140 out of each,
I'll take 120 out of Buxton. Either
I would take anything over 90. I don't even think that he's even fucking hit 100 since. When was the last time he hit 100? Let's see.
I'll tell you right now. Byron Buxton last played in
2017.
Games. All right, you got to me first. You got to the first.
Last year was his second career high with 92, which he also had in 2016.
Right, he had a 140 in 2017.
His other, and then his third most that he's ever had was 87 in 2019.
19.
And then after that, 61. So.
Right, and if you want to put it on the path, you know, 2020, the 16th season, he did play in 39. So there was a good chunk there, but.
Yeah. And just, I mean, like, everyone talks about how great he is.
And he, when he's healthy.
Don't get me wrong.
He's one of the most dynamic players.
The dude in 92 games hit 20 home runs. Granted, he only hit 222, but still.
And drove in 51, but you know.
Yeah, but.
Right. But his OPS plus was 135.
Yeah.
And, you know, to just for reference, really, from 19 to 22, his OPS plus has been 137 between those seasons. So when he's healthy, he is dynamic. Now, obviously, that includes a shortened 2021 season with 61 games. But he was on 61 games. He hit 19 home runs in 21.
He played two-thirds of the season in 2020.
Yeah, yeah, and he had 13 home runs. The dude's a dynamic player.
Oh, he is.
He can't stay healthy.
Exactly. I mean, that's really what it boils down to. He can't. I never expect him to at this point. There's no way. I mean, this dude is never going to stay healthy. Same thing with Correa, right? Like, realistically, at this point, is he really going to stay healthy? No. Just got to be honest about it, right? So.
Yeah, it's. It sucks, but. It sucks, but it is what it is. And in my opinion, the AL, that's the story to watch, is the Twins' health. Because if Kepler's healthy and he's on, he's just as dangerous too. I think he's had a rough couple of years with health and performance and such. So another one, just.
So who would you throw on the outside of the wild card in the AL?
White Sox. I have the White Sox on the outside.
That's it?
The Rays. Yeah, and I don't want to be this guy, but you know, Trout and Otani, the Angels should always be right there on the outside. But they just always underperform every year. So I don't even want to say that they're gonna be close. I don't know.
It's possible.
It there's yeah, that's the thing. It's always possible. He's only got two of the best players in baseball.
and they were phenomenal for through the first 2 months of the season, right?
Yeah.
But so I would say the Angels, the Orioles, White Sox, Rays. Who else did we say? Did we say anyone else? No.
We talk about the Twins
and Rangers.
The health.
That is six teams that I would say are really vying for that last wild card spot.
And if all goes well and the schedule does what it's supposed to do, it's going to be a very fun last few weeks of the season.
Hopefully. You know? By the way, I just remembered, just to really beat the Phillies when they're down, they open up against the Rangers. They play opening day.
So the first series is DeGrom, Eovaldi, and Heaney.
Yeah, I mean whoever the fuck it is, they get DeGrom again.
Opening day.
Dude, I mean they couldn't avoid him. It just had to happen. Really, just opening up opening day really, really, really sorely. Just get through those five innings, guys, and you'll be fine.
Four and two thirds. Who do you got coming out of the AL? I know in years past we've gone through our brackets, but who you got coming out of the AL?
Yeah, we'll do brackets on the Instagram. We'll do that. Who do I got coming out of the AL?
Hear it.
Maca, don't hate me.
Let's hear it.
Yankees.
Oh gosh.
Going Yankees. You know,
I want to say the Yankees. I really do.
Do you remember who we all four of us last year picked the same two teams?
It was Dodgers, Blue Jays, right?
Yep. And then I don't remember who. I think it was me and Mike picked the Blue Jays, and you and Mac picked the Dodgers to win it.
Yeah. Yep.
So, and then
I'm gonna go a little differently because and this is gonna sound I know you're gonna hate me for this. But until someone can beat them, until the Yankees can prove.
Why would I hate you for that? That's obvious. They're the obvious answer.
Yeah. You're going to hate me for going for the obvious answer. But until they can be, the Yankees can prove that they can beat the Astros, if they don't do that in the regular season, they're not going to do the playoffs. Until a team proves that they can handle the Astros at full strength, in general, it's the Astros going back to the World Series. Obviously, with the loss of Verlander and the pitching is a question, but it's the Astros. And it's been next man up for as long as we can remember.
Is it a question?
Not really. That's what I'm saying. Compared to years past without Verlander, yes. But until someone can prove that to knock him off the top of the mountain, the Astros are coming out of the AL for me.
Yeah, I mean, I agree.
I hate it, but it's the truth. Because I know I get so much shit from Yankee fans. Oh, you're an Astros fan. Yeah, fuck you. No. No.
There's no way.
They're here. Everyone else is down here. It sucks to say because, you know, and it's March right now. March Madness has been chaos, right? Number one seeds going down, upsets all over the place.
Absolutely.
You
want to
see that. You want to see that in baseball. You want to see a team like the Orioles beat the Astros in the playoffs. You want to see these smaller underdog wild card teams.
Who wants to see everyone that hates the Astros wants to see that.
Right, but I'm just saying it would be good for baseball seeing upstart teams like that beat the David beat Goliath kind of thing.
I would agree, but
it makes it fun.
No. I agree as a baseball fan.
Right.
But.
Right. As a baseball fan, yes.
As we know, everyone was pissed off that it wasn't one of the big dogs in the National League.
Right.
Everyone was pissed off that it was the Phillies and Padres. You know?
But the Phillies provided us Phillies great entertainment. I mean,
that
got hot.
No, I agree.
And it was good for baseball that the Phillies there because that's such a likable cast of characters. Between Ranger Suarez, you know what I'm saying.
I agree, but I'm just saying a lot of people were pissed off about it. So is it better for baseball? I don't know.
I'm going to say yes, because the problem is people don't want to realize that it could signal the changing of the guard. Mm-hmm. And then there's a new team to hate, or it could show that your team could have a chance unless you're a Reds fan or a Tigers fan, or you know what I mean? You know, if one of these smaller underdog teams comes up and beats these big time clubs. I mean, let's be real. How many times were we rooting for anyone to beat the Dodgers in the playoffs for the last 5 years?
I don't know.
Regularly.
But
people were sick of seeing the Dodgers, right?
I'll take the Dodgers over the Phillies and Braves.
Right. But you know what I'm saying, right?
I don't hate the Dodgers, though, personally. They're good. They're good. They're built good. They're a phenomenal team. I mean, how can you really? That's the only reason you hate them, you know?
Hate is because they end those kind of thing. Yeah.
They don't do anything to me. What's the fucking difference? If the Mets don't make the playoffs, then why do I hate them or not, you know?
Fair. All right. Anyway, so let's get into this real quick.
It's boring, more so, I would say.
Yeah. Okay.
Yep.
So you had the Mets versus the Yankees in the World Series.
Yes, sir.
What do you got?
Yankees.
In?
Seven.
Okay. And I had Padres and Astros, right?
I'm gonna do you one up, actually.
But what you got?
Aaron Hicks will be World Series MVP.
Not IKF?
Not IKF. He'll be ALCS MVP.
ALCS? All right.
Yeah.
What about Josh Donaldson?
No, I'm serious. Aaron Hicks is going to be World Series MVP.
Dude, can you imagine the fuck you that would get to Yankee fans? Oh my, they'd have fucking aneurysms. That would be the biggest Yankee trivia question of all time. Who was the World Series MVP of 2023?
The GOAT.
Thinking Rizzo, Judge, IKF.
Mr. 30-30 himself.
Bader. No, it's Aaron fucking no.
Yeah, but you had Astros.
I had Astros, Padres. I'm gonna go Astros and six. Again, it comes down to until someone knocks them off. I can't see it.
Can I ask you something?
Yeah.
When was the last time we had a repeat World Series winner?
That's the what was it? The 90s. Right?
With the Yankees? 99-2000.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck it.
It doesn't happen anymore.
I think it could.
I don't.
Okay. I can tell by picking the Yankees and Aaron Hicks.
Yeah. I mean,
I think we see a repeat for the first time in a long time.
It's possible that the Astros make it to the World Series. I think if they make it to the World Series, it's very, very unlikely that they win it.
Okay. I can see it. I see both sides of the coin, you know. But like I said, until someone can show me that they can really beat them in the playoffs,
mm-hmm.
It's a safe pick, but it's the pick.
Okay.
So, those are my picks. Let's go into awards.
Sir.
How you want to do this?
However you want to do it. I don't have a graphic for it, so.
So let's start with the Manager of the Year awards, because that doesn't really mean much to most people.
AL or NL?
Dealer's choice. What do you got?
All right, we'll start on the AL.
All right. Who's your AL Manager of the Year?
Pedro Grifol.
With the White Sox, right?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to go Terry Francona. What do you got in the NL?
Whoa. Macca gave us his picks.
True.
So we'll throw his in. He had Aaron Boone for the AL manager.
That must have killed him to say that.
No, you didn't see his text.
I did.
He actually picked Phil Nevin.
I don't know which one's worse.
Probably Nevin.
Yeah.
Aaron Boone is goated.
So who did he have in the NL?
Guy in baseball. Oh, that's how you want to do it? Okay. He had Buck Showalter. Who do you have?
I had Ollie Marmol.
I have, should I say, Buck Showalter.
When was the last time we had a repeat manager of the year?
You know? I have literally zero clue.
Zero idea, right? Because this means nothing. Got it.
Not something I study.
No, let's go to the rookie of the year.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there's a lot of young guys that can make an impact this year. And it's tough because a lot of these guys are like, you know they're going to come up. You just don't know when.
Mm-hmm.
Like, a lot of these guys.
Yeah.
Who do you have winning the AL Rookie of the Year?
I'll give you Mackers first. Mack, I had Gunnar Henderson.
Right, which I feel like is a safe pick.
It is. 100%. I mean, top prospect in baseball, I'd say that's a pretty safe bet.
Yeah.
I'm going Hunter Brown.
With the Astros. I like that pick a lot.
Yep. He's really good.
He's on the on the outside, mostly because I forgot about him. I have Gunnar Henderson as well, but, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if, you know, Anthony Volpe comes up. Yeah,
there's plenty of guys.
Logan O'Hop, mm-hmm. the Angels behind the plate. You know,
I heard someone say on the Angels broadcast mm-hmm. during a spring training game.
Wayne Randazzo?
It wasn't Wayne. It was someone else filling in, I'm all assuming. Right. Or maybe the Angels actually might have been away. I don't remember. But it wasn't Wayne.
Anyway.
And they said Logan O'Hoppy.
Interesting. Yeah, I don't know how it's pronounced. I know he's a Long Island guy, but I also know he's legit. You know,
he's good.
This is a kid who is going to be a backstop of the future for the Angels, hopefully, for them.
Because mm-hmm.
I've seen nothing but good things for him. So he'll be in contention, but I have Gunnar Henderson. Who did Maka have in the NL?
He had Kodai Senga.
Senga. I'll never forget throughout the entire process. You just texted me, Senga, in all caps, three Sengas in a row whenever any news about him to the Mets is coming.
Hell yeah.
Who do you have?
Corbin Carroll. I mean,
yeah.
Number two prospect in baseball, so.
And he's going to start the year.
Can't miss. Level. Yeah.
He's so good.
Yeah, I wanted to pick one that I knew I was going to be right on, you know.
Yeah, I didn't want to pick Corbin Carroll because I had the Astros. I'm picking the Astros and Gunnar Henderson, so I want to mix up a little bit. I'm going with Brett Beatty. I mean, what he's done this spring is phenomenal. And
yeah.
Especially if they're going to cut rough. Yeah, because they're going to cut rough. Escobar could slide into that right-hand DH platoon. Giving Beatty at bats as well and at their base and boom.
No, I think we could see Escobar floating around playing a bunch of different positions.
He and Guillorme will be like super utility guys.
Yeah. The Mets have a lot of versatility. It will work out.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm not worried. Cy Young
in the AL.
All right. I'll start here. I go Alec Manoa. Guy's been a workhorse, has been leaning up to it. I like Manoa a lot, but again, this is an award where you can get any number of guys.
Yeah. Who did Maca have? Plenty. Maca had Christian Javier.
I like that.
Sneaky pick.
Who do you have?
Alec Manoa.
Hey, let's go!
Him last year, and I think he gets over that hump this year and really breaks through.
Yeah, and I'm excited for that. Like he's such a fun guy to watch, too.
Yeah.
Another guy who I wouldn't be surprised is Dylan Cease after the year he had last year at the end of it. If he can continue that.
Entire year, he was fucking nasty.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. There's a lot of guys. I mean, even Shohei.
Mm-hmm.
That might be the biggest problem with Shohei is the innings. Otherwise.
That's why I didn't pick him.
Yeah. That's really why I didn't pick him either, but.
I'm glad we're on the same page in the NL Cy Young race.
All right. NL. NL Cy Young.
Yeah, I have Zach Gallen. I like that Zach Gallen stuff. I think, you know, that back end of last year, dude, he was just so good.
Yeah.
And, you know, when he's not injured or dealing with a horrible defense behind him, he has been fantastic. His stuff is there. Stuff plays.
Yeah.
He's in a big ballpark.
It could play as a hitter's park, though.
It could, but I got Zach Gallen. I think he's finally going to jump over the hump like Manoa.
Okay. Yeah, that's a good pick. Yeah, Corbin Burns.
Okay, that's a safe pick. But then again, he's angry, though. He's going to be angry at the Brewers. I don't think he's going to be on the A game. Because remember, he's the reason that they didn't go to the playoffs last year. Allegedly. Say it with straight face, dude.
I also picked Corbin Burns.
Yeah, it's a good pick.
There's nobody better in the NL right now.
No. I mean, you can argue Sandy, but we talked about his underlying numbers. Not great.
No, you can't. It's 1 year. Corbin Burns has been doing this multiple years now. Mm-hmm. Sandy puts it up again this year, and he actually fucking strikes out a few more guys. Sure. I'll put him equal to Corbin Burns.
Right.
All right. AL MVP.
I feel like there's only two choices here at this point in baseball. It's Judge or Otani.
Oh, like Trout as a candidate.
I think he's going to be overshadowed again on his own team. I'm going to go Judge going back to back.
Okay. Interesting.
I also just really like Judge.
Maka had Shohei Otani.
And the fact that I have more faith in Aaron Judge than Maka does is scary.
And he doesn't pick Yankees for awards.
That's true. Doesn't want to jinx it. Fair. So Brett Bay is not winning Rookie of the Year. Got it.
And I originally was going to pick Jose Ramirez.
Dude, J Ram's got to win one of these years, dude. fair to him. I feel so bad, dude.
That's what I was thinking, right? But then I was like, do I pick J Ram or do I be right?
you're going Shohei.
So I'm picking Shohei Ohtani, yeah. Get him in that contract year. Get him an MVP. And get him that $500 million contract. That's how I think it's going to roll. All right.
Dude, it's. I feel so bad for Jared. The dude is literally an MVP any year, but he's dealing with Shohei and Judge. Unreal.
I mean, and Trout. He was dealing with Trout, and it just, you know,
can't do it. Yep.
Just got that one guy that edges him out. Poor J Ram. Hall of Famer though. So.
Oh yeah. NL. Funny dude.
Oh yeah.
NL MVP. Who did Maka have?
Maka had Trey Turner.
A little WBC bias.
Yeah. All right.
I'm going to go Nolan Arenado. I think he repeats what he did last year.
Interesting.
What do you got?
I'm going to go with... Can you guess, actually? Yeah, I'll give you one guess.
Do I get a hint?
Well, you could ask a question. I'll give you two questions to ask, and then you get your guess.
What division is he in?
NL East.
Is it a Met?
Yep.
You're going Big Meat Pete, aren't you?
No. Going Francisco Lindor. So.
Time he finally wins one, too.
Huh?
It's time he wins one, too.
Yeah. So, you know, originally I was debating, you know, maybe Freddie, maybe Nolan Arenado.
Right. And it's another award with so many guys. Freddie Arenado.
Maybe Soto, maybe Machado, maybe Acuna, maybe him, maybe him, maybe him, maybe him.
Right.
But, like I said before, I went and I looked at the stats going after 2017. After the World Baseball Classic,
Big year for Lindor.
And he popped off. He increased his home run totals by quite a bit. And third year in New York, he's comfortable. He's loved. He loves New York. Popping off. He's going to win MVP.
That'd be cool.
That's my pick. The That'd first. Awesome. He'll be the first in Mets history.
Mm-hmm. Isn't that something?
Yeah.
Crazy stuff. Real quick, let me go over some milestones to watch this year, because obviously we love milestones, big things. You know, it's cool for the game. Okay. Justin Verlander is 6 wins shy of 250. 300 win mark obviously is not a thing anymore.
Wow.
It's not. Verlander would be, if he ends up getting to that point, would be the 25th member of the 301 club.
Hmm. Yeah, I mean.
But he's 6 shy of 250 right now. Clayton Kershaw is 3 wins shy of 200. And he's
kind of surprising. I feel like he should have more.
He's 12 wins shy of tying Don Drysdale for number 2 in Dodgers history. 36 behind Don Sutton. Zach Greinke is chasing 3,000 strikeouts. He's at 2,882. 118 strikeouts away. What do you think? Does he get it? He got 73 punchies last year, 26 starts.
No.
You don't think he hits it?
He's not the strikeout guy that he was.
No,
not at all. Well, I mean, not that he was ever really a big strikeout guy, but I could only imagine what his numbers are down to now. He's probably like 6.
Right. He had 73 last year and 26 out. It's just, yeah. Giancarlo Stanton is chasing 400 home runs.
Really?
He's at 378. So 22 home runs away from.
That's plausible.
From 400.
That's plausible.
That'd be cool. Yeah. If it happens.
He stays on the field.
If it happens, he'll be just the 22nd player to reach 400 home runs by his age 33 season.
Mm-hmm.
We got a couple of fan favorites chasing 2,000 hits. Jose Altuve with 1935, which is going to be set back a little bit. He'll definitely get that. But... And then Freddie Freeman at 1903.
Hmm.
Craig Kimbrell and Kenley Jansen are both looking at 400 saves with new teams. Kimbrell at 394, Kenley at 391.
I feel like Kimbrell should already have 400.
You'd think, right? It's weird.
Been around forever.
Let's see. Those are the big ones in this article. But some big milestones. Some big names and. Elvis Andrus is chasing 2,000 hits. Let's see. I don't know how many he's at now. Some of them say it. He's 3 hits away, so he'll get that.
Yeah.
Nolan Arenado is 1 home run away from 300. So some cool milestones that we're looking at.
Not bad.
Some big names. You know, I like milestones. I think it's cool, good for the game. It's good for a player. It's good to be recognized. A lot of guys on new teams as well.
Yeah.
Trying to reach these. So. Just stuff to look forward to. What's one thing you're looking forward to this year, Billy?
How do I pick one? Baseball. Just baseball. That's it. That's it. Baseball.
Easy answer right there. I like that. You stole my answer, though.
Why ask the question?
Listen, I'm just looking forward to getting back to the ballpark, paying $15 for a beer, trying some new menu items that the Mets rolled out this year.
Fucking $70 for parking.
Yeah, right. 40 fucking insane. Looking forward to getting down to Philly to visit the new ballpark. You and I are going to be down there June 24th.
Sadly.
Yeah, I know you don't look forward to Philly at all.
Why would I? It's Philly.
Aside from the people we got down there, but that'll be a fun time. Hopefully we'll be back in one piece.
The fuck? I will.
Tell you that you much. Will be. You will be. I may stay down there for the Supernatural game or so. Who knows?
Oh, God bless. I'll come back that night.
Oh, man. Yeah, I'm excited, man. Ready. I'm excited for a new year. New start. Excited to watch Senga. Excited to watch Verlander. Yeah. Verlander on at the home opener. Oh, man, I can't wait, dude.
Have fun.
I think my dad and I are going up.
Yeah.
And I know you said you can't make it this year.
Yeah. I got one more thing, actually. Into my mind that I am very excited about, and that is the third annual World Pod Classic.
Oh, dude, we're coming for blood this year.
We're out for blood, baby. That's funny. Blood. Did you read my bottom third that I made?
I did.
Oh, okay.
No, I didn't actually. I just knew it was going to be there because that's what we've been saying. You and I have been saying this for a couple weeks now.
Yeah, I hear you read it.
Did I? Thought, who knows?
I thought you were coming off the dome. We're on the same piece, but nah. But go on.
But no, you and I have been saying this for weeks.
Yeah.
And we're out for blood. Mac is ready, dude. He has his list. He's draft is Sunday. Yep. We have the third overall pick.
Yeah.
I don't know how I feel.
In case you didn't know, 3 was always my number. 3 is my number, man. So
you and Mac and may have to carry the draft this year, though. You guys
this year?
Yeah. Well, fuck you,
Mac. This kid's trying to say that we haven't always carried the draft. What is this? Get the fuck out of here. Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Oh, you can't hear it. I hope it shows up on there. I hope it shows up on there. It says, "You big fucking pussy." So, nah, I'm kidding. But what are you talking about?
Okay, when it comes to you and Mako, proud of you, man.
No, seriously, what are you talking about? Why are we gonna have to carry it?
I may not be able to make it. You know, I have to have some plans with the family. Celebrate
at what time? 26th
on the 26th. I don't know. We're going to Swing Bellies.
So?
I don't know what time it's going to be. We'll see.
It's Long Beach right there.
Yeah, we'll see. Who knows?
You're going to have to let me sign into your fucking Zoom account then.
I can set it up for you. It's fine. But yeah, third pick overall. 16-team league. A third of the league dropped out from last year?
Something like that, yeah.
I think we're one of, what, 6 OGs left?
Yeah, 6. That's including Sunday league. So if you really count them,
wow! FAU beat Tennessee in the Sweet 16. Oh, that fucking sucked.
Oh wow. Oh wow. That's so crazy.
Holy shit! So I lost out some money there.
How could they do that? Who saw that one coming?
1.8% of people in the tournament challenge.
What the fuck? That is so crazy.
You're the worst.
Why?
You're the worst.
Why? You're the worst.
Anyway.
Fuck you. Fuck you, you little itch. You're such a little itch. You're a little...
I hate you so much.
What?
I hate you so much sometimes.
I'm a ventriloquist.
You're fucking something, bro.
Ventriloquist? What do you want from me?
Check out the other podcast on the network.
Hold up. Yeah, I do have something else. Give me your best ventriloquism right now.
I can't.
Give me your best.
I'm not good at it.
Give me your best.
I won't. I'm not going to embarrass myself. I've already embarrassed myself on the podcast enough.
What are you talking about? When have you ever embarrassed yourself? It's only embarrassing if you think it's embarrassing. Why are you embarrassed?
Yes, and I know me pretending to be a ventriloquist is embarrassing.
Why is that embarrassing? Show me.
It's bad.
Give me your best one.
Fine.
Come on. Fuck, I just did it for like 5 minutes. I'll let you take a sip of water. That's fine.
You probably can't even hear it. Can you?
No, I didn't hear anything.
Yeah, so I'm able to talk with my lips closed.
What are you That's talking how I do. about?
No. Like my lips are,
Does that
I can.
count? That's humming.
No,
Yes, it
it
is.
is not humming the way I do. No, fuck you.
Yeah, it is. That's humming.
Anyway, I cannot be a
Record
ventriloquist.
a Snapchat of yourself and I'll put it in post.
No, I'm not doing it, man. I'm not doing it.
Fine. Then if you don't do it, actually, what can we make a bet on? Because I got a good one. Oh, speaking of bets, when we get
Uh-oh.
to 100,000
Oh my
subscribers,
God, no.
100,000 followers on
No, what
Instagram, this
happens out there?
everyone
No.
needs to know this. When we get to
No.
100,000, I have a little story. Actually, I'll tell you first. Hot ones. Hot ones. You see this? I have the sauce pack, which means it comes with the
Oh,
last
man.
dab,
Yeah.
which is the hottest fucking sauce on earth, supposedly. I tried it. It's not that bad. So I'm gonna backtrack to a little story that took place in 2018, I believe it was. Me and Max and
Dude,
another
I have the spice tolerance of fucking dog.
me, Max and another,
Nope.
we go to Buffalo Wild Wings, and you know
Oh,
there were
golly,
some sports
this.
games on. I think the Mets might have been on, and you know we were
Yeah,
just
I think so.
talking, we were eating. I'm watching the game, and you know Max got, I think you got honey barbecue and
Parmesan garage, yep.
garlic parm. So, we're talking, and I hear this kid's, a little coughing action. I'm like, what the fuck? So I look over at kid's fucking red as can be.
Blaming me on the podcast, huh? Yeah,
Red,
see how it is.
just red.
Just blame me.
Why is this flaming you? You're just intolerance.
I can't, dude. I sweat like a motherfucker when it
This isn't
comes to
flaming.
the spices.
Some people can't take spices. I can.
It's not that I
So,
don't like it. It's not that I don't like it either.
no, you just can't
I
handle it.
enjoy the garlic parmesan
Here's
wings,
the thing.
genuinely.
You physically can't
Right.
handle it. So anyway, this kid is fucking sweating bullets. So anyway,
Sweating just thinking about the last dab. Oh,
when
man.
we get to 100,000 subscribers on YouTube and
And
100,000 followers on Instagram, Max will
wasn't
do.
TikTok one of them too?
I
Or
added
just
that in to be nice,
okay.
but TikTok's probably the easiest one. So yeah, TikTok too, whatever. If we're getting 100,000 on YouTube, we have millions on TikTok. So put it this way.
Sweating just thinking about this.
This kid will sacrifice
My fucking mouth.
every ounce of fucking sweat that's in his body will be pouring out.
Dude, I'm literally, I could feel myself starting to sweat just thinking about this.
And I'll take it too, obviously.
Oh my God.
And it will be the same amount as they do on the show. It's just a little bit. At 100,000, Max will do the last dab live on YouTube. Actually, it'll be live on everything. We'll go live on everything for Max to do the last dab.
It's gonna hurt.
That's all I
It's
got.
gonna fucking hurt,
Thank you
man.
for reminding me.
It's gonna hurt.
Actually, I kind of reminded myself. What
Yeah, you
was the other
did.
punishment? Oh, it wasn't even a punishment.
What was it?
Oh, I was gonna say, let's bet on something, and if I win, we have to plug your phone in on Tinder, and we'll go through Tinder for an
Oh my
episode.
God. No, I would not agree to that.
What? Oh, that's so lame. Come on.
No. Check out all the other podcasts on the network. If you made it this far, shout out to you. I'm sweating. On the power play, got a rebrand, check them out. And from the
If you,
tips.
yep. Sorry, I thought you were
And
done.
then we're gonna be bringing back the cut at
Oh
some point
yeah,
in the next
what's got
year or so.
another rebrand?
Another rebrand, and that's gonna be, I'm excited about that. We got some meetings lined up for that one. You and
Yeah.
I, producer Billy is on the scene with this one,
God.
and I made him a deal too. I made him a deal. If we get a certain guest, Producer Billy is going to get a 5 to 10 minute segment with said guest where I have no interference. And if this happens, I will tell you this right now. It will be must listen podcasting. I have never seen Billy fanboy for anyone. And I think this would actually happen if I got this guest. And it's a very possible guest too.
Yeah.
It's very attainable.
You have a connection.
I have a connection. And so if this happens, Billy might need a new pair of pants. He might fanboy that hard. It's going to be a phenomenal episode if it happens. And just a little teaser to get you ready for the new season and then the reboot of The Cut. I'm excited about it. I know Billy's excited about what we have in store. Hopefully we can get everybody else excited. But nothing's locked in yet. Just a little teaser there. It's the official announcement that there's a plan for a reboot.
That's it.
I'm so ready. Ugh.
And if, make sure, by the way, if you really want to see Max do the last dab, like, comment, subscribe, send it to every friend you know, send them our Instagram page. Let's get us to 100,000. We need to see this kid do the last dab. He might end up in the hospital. That's all I got.
Oh my God, I hate it here. It was one other thing I wanted to say. Oh yeah. Mm-hmm. Enjoy your opening day. For all of our socials for content leading up to opening day and including opening day. Yep. We're gonna post something on Instagram. I think within the next couple of days. We did it last week. We want to hear your walk up songs going into opening day. We want to know what you're rocking out to when you step up to the box or on the mound. We want to know, let us know. We're gonna create a playlist, throw it on our YouTube. Our YouTube still has the playlist from 2021, some bangers, some real randoms, a great mix of songs, real random. You and I were listening to it the other day when we were throwing.
Yep.
Yeah, stay tuned for lots of content this year. 2023 is going to be a big year for Take a Pitch. We hope you're going to be along for the ride with us. And happy opening day. Let's go, Mets. That's it. Episode 132 in the books.
Sure.
I forgot how many of those two I went like this. Wow. So 132 in the books. I'm Max. He's Billy. You already knew that, though. Check us all out. Peace.
Love you. Bye.
It's Tito Made.
Yee, yee, yee. I'm proud of you.